Mood, I wanna cry.
¿Cómo estás, pinche pendeja? Vete a la verga, pinche pendeja, mamá verga, pinche pendeja. ¿Cómo estás, pinche pendeja? Vete a la verga, pinche pendeja, mamá verga, pinche pendeja. ¿Cómo estás, pinche pendeja? Vete a la verga, pinche pendeja, mamá verga, pinche pendeja. Ea, ea, ea.
Hola familia metiche, ¿cómo están pendejas? Espero que se la estén pasando rete bien, porque si no ya saben que aquí estoy yo para entretenerlas. Before we get started with today's video guys, let's cut to a quick commercial break. What is up you guys? Today's video is sponsored by my friends over at Scentbird. For those of you guys que obviamente no saben what Scentbird is, escucha pendeja porque te voy a decir. Scentbird is a fragrance subscription program that gives you the opportunity to shop from over 600 brands. This subscription is so flexible that it gives you the opportunity to skip any month without any penalties. They let you choose one designer fragrance every month for only $16. I love that they are so travel friendly, yet contains so much product that you literally could just throw it in your bag and you're ready to go. Each fragrance does come with 30-day supply, so you can try out each fragrance without having to commit to the full-size bottle. Y si te gusta mucho, you can go ahead and upgrade to receive 2 to 3 fragrances a month. I am trying out the Gucci Bloom perfume. I've been trying to get this perfume, but I've always been so backed off on the price, especially because I'm like, what if I don't like it? But now with Scentbird, you guys, it's gonna be so easy for me to decide whether I wanna make that big purchase because I get to go ahead and try it out before I commit to the full-size bottle. Scentbird goes ahead, you guys, and works with top designer brands such as Prada, Gucci, and Versace, as well as indie brands such as Vince Camuto, The Harmonist, and Confession of a Rebel. Super easy for you guys to go ahead and find your perfect scent based on your preferences, previous purchases, and your quiz answers. Scentbird will go ahead and help you find the fragrance you love. They sent me the Gucci Bloom. This one has Ragoon Creeper, Tumber Rose, and Jasmine Bud. This fragrance transports the wearer to a soft, dreamlike world where flowers are preparing to bloom. This is how your perfume will come. It is in this cute little twistable tube, as you guys can see. And right here is your perfume. Como pueden ver, it has a lot of product. Even with generous application, this will last you a good time. So I'm just gonna go ahead and twist it and apply some. Por si me besa, por si me abraza, y por si se pasa. Mood! This one smells so good. What the hell? You know when someone smells so good and you want to hug them? Well, just me applying this on you guys, I want to hug myself. That's how good it smells. Another perfume that they sent me, you guys, is from the brand called The Harmonist, and this one's called Hypnotizing Fire. This one has Pimento Berries, Bulgarian Rose, Patchouli. Guys, sorry. This has really bougie ingredients. Sounds expensive. I kind of want to smell this one. Nomás por nomás. Oh my God, that smells really good. This smells like a rich lady. Like, if you wanna feel bougie, put this on. Prada Luna Rosa Sport scent, as well as this Sanctuary Amour Leopard scent. This one looks really, really fancy, you guys. This one has crisp apple, rosemary, leaf pine, tonkin bean, and leather wood. That smells so fresh, you guys. This gives me very, like, I'm going to the antro, I'm going to the club vibes. Like, I'm sorry, you guys. I'm telling you, this sounds expensive. This is the Pimentree Tree and Vinegar scent. As you guys can see it right there, this one has bergamot, mandarin, balsam fir, cider, and vetiver. I have a lot of perfumes. When I have a lot of big-sized perfumes, they normally just sit down on my counter and collect dust. So Scentbird is gonna make it so easy for me to try new perfumes without having to buy the full size. It's so travel friendly that you can literally pop them in your purse and it makes you use them more because you can take them with you. So cuando estás en la calle, hueles a culo, and you're good to go. If you guys want to go ahead and try them out, I will leave a link down below. Don't forget my discount code ALANIZE to get 30% off your first order, which makes your first month only $11, you guys. So with that being said, you guys, we'll go back to our video. Wow, muchas gracias a mis amigos over at Scentbird for sponsoring today's video. Gracias a ellos, se pagó la luz aquí en mi casa. Today, we are celebrating Father's Day. Hoy vamos a ir a la casa de mi hermana because everybody's over there already. Everybody was celebrating Father's Day desde anoche, pero hoy es el meritito Father's Day. I couldn't really go to my sister's house yesterday because, one, I didn't have a ride. I can't really be driving for a really long distance, especially especially at night because my eyes. So today me está haciendo el favor mi hermano para llevarme and aprovechando él para ir para allá también. We're gonna go celebrate Father's Day today. Allá está mi abuelito, mi papá. I think my tíos might be over there. I don't know. I think Gretel va a hacer ceviche, so we're gonna have a good time in familia. I kind of want to show you guys lo que les hice. Got my grandpa and my dad money, but I also made them these. Miren, I made them a little pastelito de cerveza. These are so cute, ¿verdad? No me pueden decir que no están bonitos, you guys. I actually did these yesterday, so ahorita les voy a enseñar cómo los hice.
So I just got here to the motherfucking store, and I'm about to get down and grab everything that we're gonna need for these beer can cakes.
So we're here at the alcohol section, and the first thing we're gonna go ahead and grab is basically your choice of alcohol. I'm gonna go more for like Modelo Corona vibe because that's what my family drinks.
Alright, you guys, so como pueden ver, it was a motherfucking complete fail. I needed obviously more things than just fucking alcohol. I only found alcohol at this store. So we're gonna go right now really, really quick to like a craft store because I still need to buy the hot glue gun, which I know I have one somewhere at home, but like de aquí que la encuentre, mejor compro otra. And then I also need to buy like the cake boards, and I also need to buy ribbon and bows. So we're gonna go ahead and head over to Hobby Lobby really quick because I know Hobby Lobby will have those stuff. So hopefully, cruzando los deditos, que si encontremos todo, so we won't have to make another round to somewhere else. Alright, you guys, so thank the fuck God they had everything that I motherfucking needed. I got a little scared because when I got to fucking Hobby Lobby, half of the store was like done. Like, I think they're remodeling. So I was like, oh my God, ojalá que no hayan quitado todo lo que necesita. Pero gracias a Dios that everything I needed was still there. So we're gonna head home right now and I'm gonna teach you guys a little quick DIY beer can cake tutorial. I think it's gonna be very fun, you guys. Yo aquí enseñándoles when I've never done it before, but I feel like it's very self-explanatory that I feel like I can explain y ustedes no están tan mensas to not understand, you know what I mean? So a las una, a las dos, y a las tres vamos a estar en mi casa. One, two. Alright, you guys, so we are home. Como pueden ver, ahorita estoy aquí en mi oficina. I look a little busted, you guys, but honestly, I haven't been wearing makeup because of my fucking surgery. So, if you don't look any better than me, don't fucking give out your opinion, bitch, because I know your ass does not wake up looking like fucking a princess. Bitch, you're the frog. I am making a 2-tier cake. If you're making a 3-tier cake, you're obviously gonna need 3 different sizes, but since I'm making only a 2-tier cake, I need 2 cake boards that are different sizes. So as you guys can see, this one will go right on top of each other. Y luego aquí tengo una pistolita, and then I have my glue, of course. I posted on my Instagram, I was like, any small businesses that make beer can cakes, y'all know I'm all about supporting small businesses. But this time, bitch, I was the small business. What if I want to support myself? What if I really genuinely think I can fucking do this? I'm not gonna lie, I did hit up a couple of you guys, and then I really thought about it, and I was like, you know what, I don't want to stress about like, oh my God, will they deliver it on time? So I was like, you know what, let me pretend I'm the small business and do it myself. ¿Qué tal que me salen chingones y luego les empiezo a vender? We're gonna go ahead y le vamos a meter el pinche glue a la pistola. Nomás con cuidado, you guys, porque no le vaya a doler a la pistola. Oh my God, it's going right the fuck in. Reminds me of my culo cuando me la meten. Se resbala para adentro. Como si nada. You're also gonna need ribbon, you guys. I got gold ribbon and I also got blue ribbon since I'm making a Modelo one. You're also gonna need bows and just any like decorative thing that you guys wanna add. Eso ya es a tu preferencia. And obviamente vas a necesitar the liquor. I honestly don't really know how much we're gonna use because obviamente I've never done this. But le vamos a tantear, you guys. Como un buen cocinero, tanteale. We're gonna get the big board. We're gonna set it down on a flat
surface. And we're gonna start kind of like playing around con la cerveza to see how many cervezas le van a caber. Aquí le cabieron 9 cervecitas bien bonitas. You also don't want to overcrowd it, so make sure it looks very nicely spaced out. Because the moment it starts looking overcrowded, it's when you kind of start looking like a fucking messy cake maker. And you don't want that because, bitch, we're trying to make it onto Cake Boss. Y luego vamos a agarrar nuestra pistolita. We're gonna add glue all over the cerveza. And we're gonna start kind of just going in. So, como pueden ver, aquí están estas. We actually only needed 7. So, as you guys can see, aquí están todas las cervecitas. They're all hot glued down to the cake board. Now, what you guys are going to go ahead and get is the smaller cake board. Obviamente, la vas a abrir. You're going to get the smaller cake board, you guys, and place it right on top. Obviously, with a little bit of hot glue. No le pongan mucho. Try to just add it like on the rims because they are going to be tearing apart the cake. So you don't want the glue to be like where they put their mouth on, if that makes any sense. So como pueden ver, aquí tenemos our two-tier little cake. It is a little heavy, but bitch, it looks really good. And it's only taking me like 5 minutes. Like, wow. Look at me doing fucking small business things. So now we're gonna get this gold ribbon, you guys, and we're gonna kind of measure it out. So we're gonna put a little bit of glue. I'm gonna start in the back just because I can see the back. Mood, it looks all ugly. And we're gonna do that on the bottom as well. Ah! Me quemé! Ow, pinche verga, estúpida marrana. Cerda idiota, me quemé los pinches dedos. See, this is why sometimes it's better to just pay someone to do it. Pa' no quemarte. Pero soy terco y soy codo y no quiero gastar, ¿verdad? I also got blue ribbon and we're just gonna go over the gold ribbon with the blue. Bitch, I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty proud of my look. Wow, so cute! And you goddamn know, bitch, que todos los papás borrachos les va a gustar ver esto. Like, some papás don't even like pastel. When you mention a beer cake, le entra. So now basically what you're gonna do, you guys, is basically you're just gonna decorate it however the fuck you want it. I'm thinking of maybe putting one on top, así. This is like the little modelito ones, you guys. Like the baby looking one. So I'm gonna put that in the middle. But I want the middle to be this way. You kind of just decorate it or like lo haces como tú quieres. I'm gonna put like a little bow here. This is the pastelito numero uno, you guys. I don't know if y'all can see it. I think it's cute. Like, for what it costed and for what it's gonna last to look that cute, I think it's really, really adorable. My dad really wants me to take a picture of it. Así. He's like, ¿cómo sabías que quería más cerveza? Dude, lo encontré ahorita ya tomando. Ahora tomo una foto. Ready?
Me la mando.
A ver, ¿dónde está tu cerveza? La que estás tomando.
No, pues no quiero que sepa tu
mamá. A ver. Es que mi mamá lo va a regañar, you guys. Son las 9, mira. Y ayer se empedaron, you guys, aquí en la casa de mi prima. My child is here. Cannoli was actually one of Peaches's daughters. Peaches only had 2 daughters, and one of them was Cannoli. Ay, no, Maggie. Look, she is tiny compared to Maggie, you guys. Maggie is huge. Brinca bien alto, Cannoli. You have a lot of energy, mama. So they're cooking it up. Mood, my cousin, she's like, I don't want my brows to show. Ooh, that looks good. Yes, French toast?
Yeah, it's an apple, it's an cinnamon caramel apple.
French that looks really good. Y lo pones en el horno, ¿no? So they also made frijoles puercos. Marte's over here tragando un pan. And then the huevitos. That looks really good.
It's good.
Nice. I'm gonna taste it. Super
caliente.
Careful, okay? Mmm, it's good. Está bien rico. It literally tastes like French toast, but just more like It's really good.
So we're gonna eat some frijolitos with huevo. This smells like pedos to me. Like, you already know if you're eating this, tus pedos te van a hueler bien feo. Then we have some salsita and some chiles jalapeños. I love this. I remember the chiquito, you guys, my mom used to get these at the, what is that company? The Tupperware, huh? Hay un pelo. Mood, the dogs are. Guys, I'm so used to that shit with my dogs. Ooh, the salsita. ¿Quién la hizo, mi tía? My tía makes the best salsa, you guys. It even smells really good.
Right now, I am literally home, and I'm actually editing this video as I'm filming this. Like, the video you guys are watching right now, I literally just took a break from editing, especially because my fucking ojitos started hurting. Like, since I'm still healing from my laser surgery, like, I can't stay looking at a computer for so long, especially because I've been looking at my computer for like 2 hours straight. Like, my eyes start like fucking tripping out. I need to take a fucking break, but I'm gonna go ahead and take this little break and kind of update you guys. I know I've been a little MIA, and me being MIA, muchas cosas han pasado. Not only have I gotten surgery, but one of my perritos got surgery as well. Mi pobre perrito. You guys, like, just thinking about it, like, me quiero poner a chillar. I really do get really sad thinking about it. Ralph recently got neutered, and if you've ever gotten like your dog's fixed, bitch, you know it's so fucking sad. Like, the way they look at you, the way they motherfucking act while they're healing is so fucking sad. It breaks my little heart. I'm in a situation right now where I'm kind of regretting doing it, but at the same time, I'm like, no, sabes que, Alan, stop regretting it. Like, you know that this surgery for Ralph is only for his well-being. Ralph got his bolas chopped off. Like, why is my fucking dog having to go through the pain of getting his balls cut off? But there's a fucking lot of pinches viejos, maniáticos, puercos, cerdos allá en la calle haciendo cosas que no deberían hacer haciendo y todavía tienen sus bolas. Explíquenme, ¿eh? ¿Eh? Explícame. He actually got his surgery on Friday, a day after my surgery, so I think he's on day 3 of recovery. He has a little cone. I'm gonna take you guys upstairs with me, but I can't really do that much this madre because he can't do a lot of like excitement or too much movement porque luego like his little scar can open up and bitch, I don't want that. Shh, we're gonna go upstairs. You guys are gonna see how triste he is, you guys. I feel like he doesn't understand. So I feel like he thinks we did this because we wanted to torture him. Ralph, ¿se puede? Ay, mi papa. Stop, 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 stop. How are you, papa? Stop, papa, you're gonna scare me. Stop, please, stop. Sit. Want a treat? Want a treat? Sit, sit.
Stop. Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Come on. Come and eat. You know you're hungry. Mood Peaches came upstairs, you guys, para darle beso a su novio. Like, this gives me very, like, I came to visit my boyfriend in prison vibes.
So I'm actually gonna stay with him upstairs for a bit. Like, that's literally what I have to do. Make sure he eats and isn't, like, playing with his piligo. Because I'm gonna show you. Hey, hey! No, you cannot do that. You guys, he literally was about to lick his balls. I'm able to show you guys. It's a little graphic, but... ow.
So we have to walk. Hey, don't. So we have to walk. Hey, stop. Hey, can you stop, papa? Can you stop touching your piligo? Go pee, go pee. Go pee, papa. Go pee. I don't know, you guys. If you guys have ever had a dog that just got fixed, y'all know how stressful it can be. But me and my baby are recovering together, huh, my papa? And it makes me, like, love him even more because I just know how strong of a doggy he is. Papa, you got surgery? You got surgery, my chulo? Go pee. Go pee, papa. Go pee. Ralph, like, has been enjoying me rubbing him. You like it when I rub you, papa? You like it when I rub you, my beautiful papa? You're a strong boy, papa. I didn't want to do this to you. You know I didn't want to, but you, I don't want you to get cancer. You guys, if you guys didn't know, if you guys don't get your dogs fixed, they run into more, like, medical issues in the long run. So, yo quiero que me dure mucho, mi papi.
So, that's my little baby. I don't know. I didn't really want to share with you guys that, like, the surgery, just because I feel like people have a lot of things to say regarding surgery, especially with dogs. But I just really wanted to share it with you guys because that's one of the things I've been dealing with outside of social media. And I feel like I haven't really shared with you guys that Ralph is going through that. But I know it's for his good. I know que obviamente it was a hard decision to take, but it was the right decision to take. I eventually look forward to doing it to my other dogs. Like, mood. I want to cry. Anyways, you guys, I'm gonna end the video here. With that being said, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and suck dick. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.